So here I have my axe blank. It's basically a big flake. That's why it's called a flake axe. It comes off one time, sometimes with one sharp edge, and sometimes even two sharp edges. Here it's obvious that this is going to be our edge. And I would like to actually, just for to make it easier, to just draw on actually what I'm talking about here. So basically this will be my axe. It's going to be here, approximately here. We have the nice convexity here. We have a razor sharp edge that will not last very long. And see. So this is going to be my axe here, side edges, the neck, the edge, and here also. And in order to make this axe, I need to use a smaller hammer stone this time. So it's good to have hammer stones in all sizes. So what I do first of all, like the flake axe is actually a very good way of getting into flintknapping. Because it sort of contains everything that you need to know about flintknapping. It's a very simple tool to make, really. But it follows a certain strategy. And if you follow it correctly, you will get a good result. So it's all about like... it's all about preparing for your next step. So, in order to finish this one, we need to first think about the side edges. So what we do is actually the bulbar side, we put that flat down in our hand, because we're actually not going to touch this area here. And we are certainly going to stay away from the edge. So what I do, I turn it like this in my hand, and I hold it 45 degrees approximately, downwards like this. And I will start, I'm not going to start here in the middle, I'm going to start towards the edges here. So I'll start here, hold it here. The thing is that we would never want to start here, because this is actually, this is our platform now. Like, we need to work in this area. If we start here, we will start actually flat flaking it, or like thinning it already. That's not what we're aiming for here. So I will start carefully towards the corners here, and I will try to make this kind of, I will take off a flake that goes inwards like this. And that way I will start making the platform that will eventually be used for the thinning afterwards. So another one here, 45 degrees. There, you see how it's slowly shaping. I will start carefully towards the edge here. There we pretty much have the side edge for the axe. Now we'll start on the other side here. It's really important that we don't take off like really small flakes here. We're supposed to take off like big pieces, not like really small ones, because we want it to be a platform that we can use later. So it's really important to take off big pieces, big flakes, like that. Here they go. Pretty much the shape of the axe here. Not exactly on the lines, but I'll leave a little bit here just in case. Right. Yeah, like that. So, next step here is actually to turn the axe so that we can start to thin it. Because the way it is now, it will not fit into an axe shaft, so we need to have it a lot thinner. But we can actually see the axe shaping up here. So what we will do now is to use the side edges as a platform for the thinning. And that will be very similar to bifacial technique actually. So what I will do, and this is really important, I'm not going to do any trimming in this direction here. Now I'm turning it, and first of all I need to build up a convexity. As we can see here, it's almost like flat and concave in certain places. So in order to start on this, we need to do like a little bit of trimming, carefully starting to work on the convexity of it. This, see how it's starting to become convex on this side here. We turn it the other way here. Building up the convexity on this side. There. See how it's now shaped? It's convex here. So that means that I can start what I'm actually aiming for next, and that's the thinning, or as we would call it in Scandinavia, flat flaking. So I will use this as a platform. And now instead of the 45 degree angle that I was using when I was making the side edges, I want to turn it flat in my hand, and I want to give it a good blow here to make it go like almost like a blade going over here. And a good place to start is usually where you have a ridge already. So I'll try to start here. Maybe I'll go like 1 centimeter in here, not on the very edge, but I'm trying to really thin this thing. Here we are thinning it. I don't have to do as much work on the other side. It's not perfect here, but otherwise it's starting to shape up nicely. And now we are at the stage where we can actually start to just shape the finished axe. I might take off a little bit of the corner here. And that means that I can get rid of this stuff here. Then I can just shape it. The idea with the early Mesolithic flake axes is that they've actually been worked a little bit like this in order to, you just go zigzag a little bit and dull the edges, the side edges a little so that they will not ruin the shaft or the socket that the axe is put inside. So, here we have sort of the finished flake axe. It's not beautiful, but it's functional, and it has really, really, really sharp edge. Normally it would take around like 4 or 5 minutes to make an axe like that, and it will probably not last for longer than 20, 30 minutes if you're going to be using it on, like, for woodworking. I don't know.